the meeting of Sir John Bennett with Mohammad Amin Sheikho.
During his work, the humane scholar Mohammad Amin Sheikho had a friend from upper-class society who had great importance during the French Mandate in Syria. He was a prince called Abdul-Majid Haydar. This prince was of distinguished position and high reputation, and was intelligent and well-educated. He had not left a scientific, literary or social field without having mastered it. He was a member of the family of Sharif Hussein in Al-Hijaz, Saudi Arabia, a descendant of the Hashemites, whose lineage goes back to Prophet Muhammad. Communication with Allah and peace are through him. Britain had crowned his relatives King Faisal in Iraq and King Abdullah in Jordan, and following the British example, France wanted to crown Abdul-Majid Haydar as the king of the Greater Syria. However, for political reasons, he became the Jordanian ambassador in London. Through his new post, he became acquainted with Sir Bennett. In one of the meetings that Prince Haydar attended with Sir Bennett, the following exchange took place.
"Prince Haydar, I have a question which has puzzled me for a long time. For 40 years I have been inquiring, examining and investigating this issue, but without results. I have never found a convincing reply or a conclusive answer. Is the world incapable of revealing this truth?
I know you are lost on a persistent search. I know who can answer your queries, unveil the ambiguity of your questions, and uncover the truth for you. I am quite certain, and I am sure of what I'm saying.
Who is this great man who will quench my thirst? Who is the one who will unveil the ambiguity of my questions? In my travels to every corner of the globe and across the biggest countries of the world, I have never met a philosopher or a meditative scholar without asking for an answer. But all has been in vain, and I always return from these meetings in frustration."
"You can achieve your aim in the Orient, in Damascus."
"In the Orient? In Damascus? And only there can I find someone who will answer my question?"
"Truly I mean what I say. If you are really interested in the answer to your question, you had better go to Syria, in which there is a great city called Damascus. Nobody will be able to answer you except a great man who lives there."
"I am ready to go to him immediately."
Indeed, following their conversation, Prince Haydar cabled his friend in Syria and informed him of Sir Bennett's impending arrival. At once, Sir Bennett contacted the airport and booked a seat on the first plane leaving for Damascus. The plane took off, piercing the clouds of the sky, traversing one country after another. Sir Bennett was inside the plane, detached from those others inside it, from its noise and from its turbulence. He mused to himself over many questions.
"Who is this great man? And from where did he get his knowledge?"
He imagined descriptions and images of this great man and kept asking himself,
"Is he actually in Damascus? Is he actually there? Is he really? What a wonder!"
The plane landed on the airport runway and its pilot announced that they had arrived in Damascus. Sir Bennett then awoke from his speculation and visions. He headed for the Orient Palace Hotel, which, until recently, was popular among foreigners because of its magnificence. The venerable scholar, Mohammad Amin Sheikho, went to the hotel accompanied by a number of his disciples for the translation of the dialogue. In the hotel, our venerable scholar warmly welcomed his guest, and after taking their seats, he requested him to ask his questions freely. During the discussion, they discovered that they both spoke Turkish. This made the atmosphere more flexible and comprehensible. They spared the translators, and Sir Bennett asked his questions. Describing the first moments of this meeting, Sir John Bennett said,
As I entered the hotel, I passed a well-dressed Syrian gentleman and a young Muslim going down the stairs. At the top, the manager said, "Those gentlemen were asking for you." I turned around and they did the same. It was Amin Sheikho. I will not write down the details of our first conversation, which lasted 2 hours, as some of the things he said were so amazing that I do not know whether to take them seriously.